You feed your face, and we'll feed your brain with the info you need to start your day.
Good morning, world. It's a brand new day.
This is Talk of the Town with Henry Hinton on 103.7 WTIB and 94.1 WNBU.
Oh, my. Okay, welcome back. It's Talk of the Town Wednesday. Nice to have you here. We got a big hour here this morning, a lot to get to. Going to be talking to a lot of folks about a lot of stuff, including this new proposal that's on the table for Greenville City budget from three of the Greenville City Council people that would avoid this tax increase that the City Council voted for last Monday night. P.J. Conley, McLean Godley, and Candy Smith have come up with an alternate proposal that they say will accomplish all the things that everybody wanted to accomplish: extra safety issues, more lighting in some of the neighborhoods and security cameras. And the big thing is street paving. And they say they can do it and not raise taxes. So, of course, we haven't heard how they're planning to do that yet. We're going to get PJ Conley on. In fact, if PJ is listening, call us, PJ, 561-8255. We don't have your cell number. All we have is an office number for you, 561-8255. We scheduled PJ right about now to talk about things. So, PJ, go ahead and call us if you can, if you're listening, and we'll try to talk about this and get a perspective on it. Trent McGee is here. Good morning, McGee.
Morning, Hen.
And Ariel Placencia is here from WITN. Good morning, Ariel.
Good morning.
We were talking about the news this morning out of Orlando. If you haven't heard the news, this is the second tragedy out of Orlando in just a matter of days after the mass shooting in the nightclub on Sunday night.
Or really third, if you think about the singer from The Voice that was...
That's true. I forgot about that. So the girl from The Voice was murdered down there last week. Yeah. But last night, if you haven't heard this news yet, last night at Disney World... At the Grand Floridian Hotel, which is really the nicest place on the property if you want to go have a family vacation and stay on the property. I've been to Disney World many times. I've been to the Grand Floridian. Beautiful, beautiful hotel. Great family atmosphere. A man and his two-year-old son were apparently in knee-deep water in the lake there at Disney World. And the two-year-old toddler was apparently taken by an alligator. Is that the worst thing you've ever heard in your life?
I can't even begin to imagine.
I think about my grandchildren. I mean, my God, I just can't imagine it happening. And Ariel, I guess as of now, they haven't located the little boy's body, have they?
No, I don't think so. And I just read a couple of things. I think the father tried to... get the boy from the alligator because he some injuries on his hands or something. But they are looking at all the... I think there's a couple alligators in that lake, and they are going to look at all of them to see if there's any evidence.
Oh, my.
So you've seen that lagoon?
Oh, sure.
How big is that?
The lake. They call it Lake Buena Vista. It's the lake where you can water ski in that lake. I mean, they have all sorts of...
So it's a lot of area to cover for those searching for the two-year-old.
It's a fairly large lake, yeah. And, the lake really kind of goes through all the hotel and campground properties and everything right up next to, you see the big A-frame hotel. What's that thing called? The Contemporary? It's not so contemporary anymore, but that Contemporary where the monorail goes through the hotel.
I've seen that. That
the lake is there. It goes out to the back of that place. It goes over to the Grand Floridian. It goes to the campground. I've had my kids in that lake. They've got one of those big wave pool deals there. I mean, when my kids were smaller, we went to Disney World several times. I was there 2 years ago with my grandchildren. But we went in March, and it was too cold to get in the water, so we didn't do any of that, and we stayed off property. But I just cannot imagine such an awful, awful tragedy.
I can't either.
This is just a terrible thing to have. And look, it's a bad thing for Disney World, too. Because you know what? Disney World's a first-class place. It's a first-class operation. It really is the happiest place on earth, as they say. When you take kids to Disney World, It's a great, great experience. You know, it's just, you can't go to Disney World and not have fun. I don't care how old you are or what you're.
Not to mention, and I know we don't have time to go into this, but, you know, Disney World came out last night and said that the Orlando shooter, they had security footage of him at Disney World back in April.
Heard that
remember
earlier.
That? Yeah, so.
So, but the question was whether or not he was there just as a tourist, or whether he was there, you know, staking the place out.
Yeah, you can speculate all of that, I'm sure.
So. So let me mention, we got PJ holding. PJ, thank you for calling. Hang just 1 second. Got a couple things I got to mention, including our Father's Day giveaway. We're down to a couple of days of having you register. You have to go to Greenville TV and Appliance or Steinbeck's Men's Shop today and register. And Friday morning, we're giving away this beautiful green egg behind me here, which is absolutely gorgeous. And if you've never tried one of these green eggs, I hear they are the deal. And it'd be a great Father's Day gift idea. They got some other great gift ideas also for Father's Day at Greenville TV and Appliance. So thanks to Malcolm Williams and the guys for providing the big green egg. And we're giving it away on the show Friday morning. You have to register to win today or tomorrow at Greenville TV and Appliance or Steinbeck's Men's Shop. Steinbeck's also has some other great gift ideas. They're giving away some stuff on Friday morning as well on the show. But if you know, Steinbeck's has got great gift ideas for dad from Vineyard Vines, Southern Marsh, Southern Tide, collard greens, bathing suits, bow ties, Southern Casanova, Coastal Cotton, and more. The ultimate Father's Day promotion, we've got it going on right now, and we hope that you will stop by and register at Steinbeck's Men's Shop or at Greenville TV and Appliance today. All right, now let's get to this breaking news here in Greenville. The Greenville City Council has been doing hand-to-hand combat for about 3 weeks on the budget. And at the last meeting last week, they decided that they were going to, in a 4-3 vote, they were going to increase taxes to pay for roads, some road construction, paving, additional police officers, safety issues. There was a dog park that was put in at the last minute. There were some other issues, and P.J. Connolly, McLean Godley, and Candy Smith voted against this, saying we don't have to increase taxes. And lost that vote 4-3. Now, the budget is not complete. We have not finished the budget. Until they totally vote on the whole budget, this is not actually a tax increase until the whole budget is approved. And so those three council people, Connolly, Godley, and Smith, have now released a press release last night. I read it last hour, that essentially says we can do all the things that we want to do, and that these folks that want to raise taxes want to do, and not raise taxes. And we're going to show you how. Now on the telephone to talk about that is Greenville City Councilman P.J. Connolly. P.J., you were on the show yesterday. I was out yesterday, but you dropped a bomb yesterday afternoon. Nobody knew this was coming. You didn't say anything about this on the show yesterday morning, I understand. So we're interested to hear your ideas about how to do all these things and not raise taxes. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on again. I did not mention it yesterday for one reason solely. I wanted the city staff to complete, you know, my proposal. What I did was I went straight to them with a proposal, you know, with my ideas, and I wanted them to vet it because, you know, the last proposal that was brought to us was sprung on us right at the city council meeting last Monday. And, you know, I wanted the city staff to go through it, and then I'd asked the city staff, once we completed this process, I wanted it to be sent out to all the council members first. I felt that that was the proper way to go about it, and I wanted them to be able to see it first. So it wasn't sprung on them, you know, tomorrow night at the very last minute, and we have to make an important decision because, I mean, ultimately, this is a really big decision for our community, and I think it's important that everybody has the knowledge in front of them before we make that decision.
All right, so now, as I understand it, this new proposal that you and the other two council members are making would add an additional $3.75 million for road paving, $350,000 for additional street lighting, $140,000 for security cameras, and then $440,000 for pedestrian safety, which was not anything that was actually really being talked about. We heard a lot about police, additional police officers and stuff like that, but well, let's start first with the road construction. Is this the same amount of money that was they said that they needed for paving?
Well, you know, talking to Kevin Mulligan, the head of the Public Works, he had said that we need about $2.5 million a year to be able to fully fund our roads on a regular basis. And you carry that out for 5 years, you're talking about $12 million of road funding. So what we were trying to do is we're coming up with ways with using our resources the best way we possibly can to come up with that funding. And we found a couple different items that we felt would be a good way to come up with that funding.
So are you talking about cutting something that's currently, money's being spent on currently? How are you going to pay for this?
There's a lot of moving parts to this, but I'll do my best to explain it to you. What we would do is we have approximately $4 million in excess fund balance that'll be available for us at the end of this year. So what my proposal would do is we would take $1.5 million in excess fund balance, and we would use, we already have $1.9 million that's allocated for a lot that we have agreed to build with a sidewalk development project that's going to go in right there on the corner of Dickinson Avenue. It's going to be an apartment complex and retail. It's going to be a mixed-use project. And what we would essentially do is we would build that deck with the money that we have available, I mean the lot with the money that we have available, and then once we complete that project, the sidewalk development project is going to lease 200 spaces from us. So we're going to create revenue based off of the leasing of those 200 spaces. And my proposal says that we're going to go ahead and finance that deck and use the revenue source to pay for the debt service for that. So pretty much what that does is it opens up, you know, a large chunk of money that we can go ahead and put towards roads right now. And one of the things that was really eye-opening to me at the meeting was, you know, we were talking to Public Works, and one of the things they mentioned was right now, if you go ahead and address your road issues, it's approximately $100,000 per lane mile. If we go ahead and wait until, you know, they crumble and they get to a really bad shape, that price, you know, multiplies by 10, and you're talking about $1 million per lane mile. So, you know, my idea was we've got to use funding now to go ahead and fix those items so we don't set ourselves up for a disaster down in the future.
So how about this $440,000 for pedestrian safety? Is that something that was currently, I don't remember that being discussed in the budget proposal before. Is this something you're adding to the budget?
Yeah, this is something that we decided to add to the budget. And one of the neat things that I brought up during the budget process during one of the meetings was, you know, historically, we have been running at about, over the last 5 years, at a 6.33 vacancy rate across the board for our employment at the city. And just this last year, they decided they were going to put in a 3% vacancy. And what we did was we ended up moving that vacancy rate up to 4%, you know, which is a little bit more in line, but it still gives us a little bit of a cushion. And that opens up nearly $400,000. And one of the things that we can do is we can use that as recurring costs or recurring revenue to pay for things like pedestrian safety. You know, talking to some other council members, talking to some people in the community, you know, that's a really hot button item right now. You know, people are really concerned about our sidewalks, concerned about our crosswalks, concerned about, you know, signage and different things like that. And that was one thing, in my opinion, that was missing from this whole equation. And you know, myself and Councilmember Godley and Mayor Pro Tem Smith, you know, all agree that this is a very big component that we need to put into our budget.
I think you're right. I hadn't heard about this before this morning, but it's very concerning that, you know, every week we sit here and listen to the WITN news people talk about someone who was hit by a vehicle in Greenville. It's gotten out of hand.
Yeah,
we've had people killed in the last year. I mean, people, college kids hit by cars, other people hit by, it's crazy. And we got, you know, something needs to be done about that. So God bless you. And I'm glad to hear something practical. You know, I'd rather spend tax money on that than another dog park in a neighborhood that's, you know, almost out of town. or you know, some of the other pet projects that kind of blew up at the last minute. Now, one of the things that you've come up with is additional money for security cameras in some of our tougher neighborhoods, and $350,000 in additional LED lighting. Again, I'm going to ask the question, where are you going to get the money for that?
That's going to come out of that vacancy. And the nice thing about the vacancy is when we move it to 4%, which is, like I said, closer in line, those are recurring revenue sources that, you know, we can use those funds however we see fit in the future.
So when you say vacancies, you're talking about money that's budgeted for positions in the city that's actually not being spent.
Yeah, and we've got historical data to prove it. Like I said, over the last 5 years, the average vacancy is 6.33%.
See, the problem with this, PJ, is you're thinking like a business person, not like a bureaucrat. You know, This is a real problem. You're actually using real numbers rather than theoretical budget numbers, which is what people in government like to do.
Absolutely.
you can't think like a business person in the government, PJ. Come on. So you're basically saying we're spending, you know, we're budgeting money that we're not spending anyway.
That's right.
But here's the question. What ends up happening to that money usually if you don't actually find a good, noble use for it?
Well, I mean, it will go at the end of the year into the excess fund balance. It'll be funds that'll be available, and at any point during the year, you know, if the city sees a need for something, if they want to spend that money in a different manner, they can go ahead and spend it.
So it sounds like what you're saying is by massaging the actual cash numbers, that you've been able to cut into the budget and find money available to do some of the things that we need to do without imposing a tax increase on people.
That's exactly right.
Have you had any response from anybody other than the other two council people who agree with you?
I have not yet. You know, I've talked to some people in the community briefly after we proposed this, and they're all on board. I mean, you can look at it from this perspective. Over the next 2 years with their proposal, you're talking about $1.986 million of additional taxes that you're going to take out of our citizens in Greenville, and our proposal takes $0 out of their pocket.
I like it. I hope you can get them to agree to it. Have you talked to city staff about this yet?
Yeah, I said. Well,
you said it was vetted by city staff, but that doesn't necessarily mean they agree with you on the idea, right? They've just looked at it and said what? It's your numbers are legitimate.
Yeah. They went through there and said it was legitimate. Like I said, the city staff, you know, in my opinion, the proper way and the proper channel to go about it is to go through here, present it to them, let them see it, to make sure it's a viable option. They went through there and looked at it, said it was. And, then we present it to the rest of the council. That's, to me, in my opinion, that's the only way to go about it, so everybody's on the same page.
All right. PJ, God bless you, man. You're thinking. That's what we like. You're thinking. You're trying to save the taxpayers' money and not have a tax increase. And this tax increase that's coming, if it's put through, is going to be on the backs of businesses in Greenville. So God bless you for working through this.
I appreciate it. Thank you for having me on today.
All right, thank you. 23 minutes after 8. Apparently, I was wrong. It was not Lake Buena Vista.
Okay.
Our website got an email saying your DJ on Talk of the Town is delivering misinformation. I'm sorry. It says the alligator attack was in Seven Seas Lagoon, not Lake Buena Vista.
Okay.
Sorry about that.
That's okay.
Which, you know, I thought it was in the Big Lake, but apparently I thought that Big Lake went up to the Grand Floridian. Maybe it does, but this was in another area of the property. I don't know. Whatever, it was tragic. All right, 24 minutes after 8. Let's get a break, and we're coming back. Area will have news headlines and then more Talk of the Town for Wednesday morning, June 15th. Be right back.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. Looking for an SUV? Come check out our great lineup of Jeeps.
Lease a new Jeep Compass for just $99 a month with a Drive and Discover event. Also check out Eastern North Carolina's largest selection of Jeep Cherokees, Grand Cherokees, and Wranglers.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile and Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308. Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile and Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son's shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. You've got to see our large selection of Ram trucks. We have over 100 new Rams in stock. That's the largest in Eastern North Carolina.
Lease a new Ram 1500 Crew for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing with the Drive and Discover event.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
McGee is taking pictures of the big green egg. You want to put those on Facebook?
No, not yet. I'm going to.
We're giving away the big green egg from Greenville TV and Appliance on Friday morning. You got to go register today or tomorrow at Greenville TV and Appliance. This thing's a $1,300 value. You can see it. It's got the big, the TV audience can see it's got the big side shelves. It's perfect. You can cook 8 steaks, 12 burgers, 20-pound turkey, 6 chickens, 7 racks of lambs, and a partridge in a pear tree.
Yeah.
You can cook all that at one time. Not all of that, but any of that at one time. It's a great Father's Day gift, and it lasts a lifetime, by the way. The other dads will be green with envy. And you can win this one, but if you can't, you can get your dad one for a Father's Day. Great stuff. It's the most versatile grill out there. Because not only can you grill, roast, you can smoke, you can bake. And I'm talking about breads, casseroles, cakes, and pies. The best, I understand, It's the best pizza you've ever eaten if you fix one of those on the Big Green Egg.
I got buddies that do that. Yeah, make white pizzas on it.
It's an airtight ceramic cooking chamber, retains heat, maintains precise temperature controls, and food keeps the food moist. And we're giving this one away Friday morning. Register today or tomorrow at Greenville TV and Appliance on Greenville Boulevard or Steinbeck's Men's Shop. We're giving it away along with some stuff from Steinbeck's on Friday morning for Father's Day, 8:30. Live in the studio this morning, tomorrow morning live in Raleigh at the legislature. We're going to be talking about all this stuff. Boy, I was over there yesterday. Negotiations are hot and heavy. In fact, our show might even end up having a negotiation tomorrow morning. I think the governor and Phil Berger might end up having a meeting right there in front of us tomorrow morning. Because they were both supposed to meet tomorrow morning. They were supposed to do the show. So we'll get our legislative leaders on tomorrow morning. And our Live at the Legislature brought to you by Greenville Auto World. Our friends at Greenville Auto World. Thanks to those guys. Sam Jones Barbecue, the Overton Group, Potash Corp Aurora, Culpepper Investments, Wells Fargo Advisors, and the North Carolina Hospital Association. Tomorrow morning, 7 to 9, live in Raleigh, Talk of the Town, live at the legislature. Be there with us. 8:31, let's go to the news desk, and Ariel Placencia standing by with the latest from WITN. Good morning, Ariel.
Good morning, Henry. The Highway Patrol says a driver has been taken to Vidant following a wreck on U.S. 13. Troopers say a truck was headed south on U.S. 13 near Ballard's Crossroads when, for unknown reasons, the driver crossed the center line and hit the railing on the bridge. It happened around 2:45 this morning. The driver has been identified. He's 45-year-old Arthur Heath. He was sent to Vidant with serious injuries, but troopers say he is expected to be okay. And Heath has been charged for driving while impaired, careless and reckless driving, left of center, unsafe tires, and wearing no seatbelts. With music from the New Century Saxophone Quartet, a community hundreds of miles away from the attack on a gay Orlando nightclub stood with the city strong and proud last night. A candlelight vigil was held in Greenville. People met in front of Crave in Uptown and marched to Town Common yesterday evening. A diverse group of speakers graced the stage, and then the names of all 49 victims were read aloud. Cries could be heard as ECU graduate Shane Tomlinson's name was read among the victims. Also, a recent Brody Medical School graduate, Dr. Joshua Corsa, also helped save many of the survivors. ECU sent out an off-campus crime notification yesterday evening regarding multiple shots fired. Kristen Hunter with the Greenville Police Department says it happened around 9:30 yesterday at 2602 East 3rd Street. She says at least one bullet struck the home, but no one was hurt. Investigators say they believe this was a targeted shooting and that there is no further threat to the public. Authorities aren't sure exactly how many shots were fired, but they do say that the suspect vehicle is a silver four-door car. They're unsure how many people were inside or where the vehicle was headed, but we'll keep you posted. And finally, authorities are investigating a drowning yesterday evening in Pitt County. The Pitt County Sheriff's Office responded to the incident around 5:40 yesterday evening near 1218 Sticks Lane, which is off of U.S. 264. Volunteer firefighters and EMS were already on scene. Deputies say a 19-year-old man was found at the bottom of a pool that's 12 feet deep by a firefighter. Rescue crews tried to resuscitate him but were unable to revive him. The Sheriff's Office's friends and family were gathered at the home for a summer barbecue, and some of them were swimming. At one point, they noticed the teen missing, and they couldn't find him, and that's when they called 911. The sheriff's office says they will release the teen's name later this morning. Time is 8:33 a.m. And Henry, those were your WITN news headlines.
Thank you, Ariel. Let's check our weather now, and here's McGee with that.
All right, partly cloudy skies for your Wednesday. Scattered thunderstorms possible in the afternoon today with highs in the lower 90s. For tonight, mostly cloudy with a lingering shower or two. Lows in the middle 70s, and for your Thursday, partly cloudy skies. Scattered showers expected late in the day with highs in the low 90s and lows in the mid 70s.
All right, very good news and weather. A service this morning of the Tire Realty Group, the official real estate team of the Pirates. And you hear us talking all the time about Homer Tire's long list of qualified buyers. Well, the Tire Realty Group has hundreds of buyers looking for specific types of homes, and they match these buyers to new homes coming on the market every single day in Greenville. Right now, Pitt County home inventory is down 25%, which is a three-year low, which means it's time to list your home. Simply aren't enough homes on the market for the number of buyers out there. For example, Tire Realty listed a home in Brandy Creek and sold it in just 10 days. So call them, 758-HOME or guaranteedsellnc.com. I'm giving the old URL, I'm sorry. Giving the old website. It's 99orfree.com, 99orfree.com. And the reason for that is because of the new 99-day guarantee. Tire Realty Group guarantees to sell your home in 90 days or they sell it for free. They put their money where their mouth is. And also Tire Property Management looking to hire a full-time property manager right now. to assist with all the new rentals they've got coming on the market. Call them at 758-HOME or visit them online at 99orfree.com. All right, 8:35, still to come. We've got Representative Greg Murphy, who was on site last night for the candlelight vigil down on the town common, and get a report on that. And also coming this weekend at Eastern North Carolina's world-class water ski venue, Beaver Lake, another huge water ski competition coming. We'll talk to Jeff Mitchell about that coming up next.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. Looking for an SUV? Come check out our great lineup of Jeeps.
Lease a new Jeep Compass for just $99 a month with a Drive and Discover event. Also check out Eastern North Carolina's largest selection of Jeep Cherokees, Grand Cherokees, and Wranglers.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MyVidant to learn how you can sign up.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. You've got to see our large selection of Ram trucks. We have over 100 new Rams in stock. That's the largest in Eastern North Carolina.
Lease a new Ram 1500 Crew for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing with the Drive and Discover event.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
All right, 8:38 coming up this weekend at Beaver Lake Ski Club. It is some of the top water ski competitors in the country coming back to Eastern North Carolina. Our buddy Jeff Mitchell, who is Mr. Beaver Lake, is on the telephone this morning. Good morning, Jeff. How are you?
I'm great, Henry. I hope you are.
It's that time of year again. You've got some of the top water ski competitors in the world, really, coming back here to Eastern North Carolina, to Gates County and Beaver Lake. This is a unbelievable water ski venue. And you got daytime competition. And as I understand it, you got some new things this year. You got a thrilling event coming up, a night jump event. Tell us about all the festivities this weekend.
Okay. Well, it's just so much going on. This event has a lot of moving parts. It's kind of, I describe it as kind of like trying to manage a three-ring circus, but we'll be starting Friday afternoon with practice, Actually, all the boys will be on site tomorrow morning from the club, setting up the lights for the weekend and getting everything staged that's not already staged. And Saturday morning, we'll kick off at 8 o'clock sharp with slalom. And we'll run the first round of slalom. And then in the afternoon, about 1:30, we'll switch over to the jump event. And both slalom and jump will have this is a pro-am format. So you'll have novice skiers on the starting dock with guys that are professional open skiers that do it for a living. So great opportunity for the fans to watch some fantastic skiing. And I'm really excited about the fact that a lot of these young amateur skiers, you know, will actually be out there being able to hobnob with some of the people that they look up to in the sport and see in the magazines and everything. So that's a great opportunity for them.
It's amazing the number of people that you get and the competitors that you get to come into this event every year. And again, if you're not familiar with Beaver Lake, we'll tell you exactly how to get there. It's easy to find. It's just over the Chowan River Bridge into Gates County. But, you know, talk about some of the people that will be there. Do you have people, you have international water skiers, some of the top folks coming in this weekend again, and people from some of the top universities and that kind of thing, Jeff?
Yeah, we do. I mean, as a matter of fact, some of the jumpers that will be competing during the day and likely will advance to the night jump event, just to name a few as far as some international flavor. You got Matt Winiger from Canada. You got Josh Bryant from Australia. You got Willie Oliver from Great Britain. And you got Alex King from New Zealand. And so these are, you know, all really good jumpers. And what's good about this group is they're all kind of, their scores on the world ranking list are very close. So that means there's not a ringer in this group. There's going to be some tight competition for the prize money.
And the neat thing about it is you're having some of the jump competition at night. And is it the first time you've done that?
No, this is the third time we've done
that. Is it?
And hopefully we keep getting a little bit better at it, because there are, as you could imagine, some logistical issues. It's not something that you get to practice very often.
And but that's kind of that'll be a neat thing. If for people who want to come out and watch the night jumping water ski competition, what time does all that start?
Yeah. Okay. We are posting a 6:30 start time. The actual show, for lack of a better word, will start at 7 p.m. You know, with the MC welcoming everyone. This will be a competition, but it will be fast-paced, and it'll be very much entertaining, like a ski show. People, I think, will stay very engaged in this. Let me just give you a quick run-through of what some things to expect at night that are different from the normal water ski tournament format. We will have head-to-head slalom starting this out. So normally in a tournament, you pull one skier at a time until he falls or misses. This is going to be where there'll be two boats, you know, with each having a driver and a boat judge, and they will each have a skier. So one skier will go out and set the pace and set the bar. The other skier will have to match it, and they'll keep shortening the rope until someone misses. So that head-to-head format's really good. We will have the night jump event. It'll still be daylight then, but as the sun sets, we'll have the top eight jumpers from the daytime competition, and they will go out there and get two jumps apiece, where the top four of that eight will cut to the semifinals, which will be four, and then those four will come back out and compete for the finals, which will be the top two.
That's cool.
And then we'll name a winner.
That's really neat. And the best part of all this, it's all free to the public, right?
Absolutely. Also, during the competition, we will, between those heats, Henry will be having some show ski exhibitions. We've got two guys that used to perform at SeaWorld. They'll be here that are fantastic barefooters and freestyle jumpers, and as well as having some trick skiers that have a great flip runs that will be right there in front of the crowd doing some fantastic flips. So like I said, it's going to be fast-paced and entertaining, and going to be a lot of fun.
And it's a family event. You do allow the kids to go swimming between the events if they want to, and Beaver Lake's a great place for that. And you do not want coolers allowed, right?
That's right. That's right. Because we, you know, we will have vendors on site that will be selling beverages. So we also will have food vendors on site, so everybody can come out and enjoy dinner and their favorite beverage as they sit there and watch the water ski tournament.
This is one of the top water ski venues anywhere, and it's interesting that it's right there in Gates County. It's 2 miles north of the Chowan River Bridge on Highway 13-158 in Gates County. So it's what, about, I don't know, 5-6 miles north of Ahoskie. Is that about right, Jeff?
About 10 miles north of Ahoskie.
10 miles.
And about 12 miles south of the Virginia state line.
And it's worth it, folks. If you've never been, I've never actually been to one of the water ski competitions, but I've seen Beaver Lake. It's just a place built for water skiing, is it not? I mean, you've done an unbelievable job up there, Jeff.
Well, I appreciate it. You know, we've had a good time. I wanted to get a couple of other things out. For more information, we have a website, beaverlakeskiclub.com, and the directions are on there, and we list accommodations within the area. We also have a Facebook page, and Facebook will be getting the quickest updates. So anybody that's interested can follow us on Facebook.
All right, perfect. Well, I hope you have great. It looks like the weather's going to be great. It's not going to be sweltering hot. It's going to be in the 80s, right around 80 degrees. So it looks like a great weekend for this.
Yeah, I think it's going to, I'm not going to crow yet, because I know how unpredictable weather can be this time of year.
Yeah.
But so far it's looking promising. So.
All right, good.
Also, just if I can, I just want to give a shout out to all of our sponsors for helping make this possible. There's several, and I don't want to start naming and leave anybody out, but they know who they are, and we couldn't do it without them. And also our officials that are traveling from far and wide to volunteer their time this weekend to make this event happen. Just much thanks. We appreciate it.
And thanks to you for this is an unusual entertainment opportunity for people in Eastern North Carolina, Jeff, and we appreciate all your work. Thank you, man. Good talking to you.
Thanks, Henry. All right. Take care. Gary Hodges says say hello.
Okay. Tell him hi. All right, let's take a break. We're coming back. 8:47, more Talk of the Town coming up right after this.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
Top Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. You've got to see our large selection of Ram trucks. We have over 100 new Rams in stock. That's the largest in Eastern North Carolina.
Lease a new Ram 1500 Crew for just $299 a month and only $299 due at signing with the Drive and Discover event.
Talk of the Town, and brought to you by one of our great sponsors, Beauty Bar Medi Spa. If you haven't checked this out yet, it's Greenville's only medical office with a spa atmosphere focusing on aesthetics. And, you know, with Father's Day coming, you don't think about Dad. Well, you never know. Dad might want a little Botox, but they have non-surgical procedures like laser hair removal, Botox, TruSculpt body contouring, medical-grade facials. They'll work around your schedule. Ladies, if you want to get involved, it's a wide selection of medical-grade skincare products at Beauty Bar Medi Spa, including Jane Iredale makeup, and work around your schedule. Call them at 752-1406. Nikki Blunt and her folks at the Beauty Bar Medi Spa can take care of you. And call them today and set up an appointment, 752-1406, for the Greenville's Beauty Bar Medi Spa. Greenville's only medical office with a spa atmosphere, and of course they focus on aesthetics for the folks that go there. I don't think Greg Murphy's had any Botox yet. I don't know. Representative Greg Murphy on the telephone. Have you had the Botox? You're just naturally young looking. You don't need Botox.
Well, I'm just rotting from the inside out. I'm like a good old tree.
Representative Greg Murphy, our House of Representatives member from Pitt County. I missed you yesterday. I was up there hobnobbing and trying to do some university work.
I missed you, too. I met with several other folks at the university and had very good discussions with them. Had a bunch of good discussions with a wonderful group of Pitt County teachers.
Good.
The amazing job that they're doing, doing a great mentorship program where they're older teachers are helping newer teachers kind of get acclimated and providing a mentor to them. And those folks are dedicated. That's not a career. It's a calling. And I think they're just doing a fabulous job with it. So.
Well, I'm going to be back up there tomorrow. Of course, we're doing our live at the legislature show tomorrow morning. I hope you're going to come over and be on with us for a minute.
Yeah, I'll be there.
We got the governor and the speaker and the president of the Senate, everybody coming over to the Daily Planet tomorrow morning. So I hope you'll come over. We were working on the Senate side yesterday, pretty much working on this Elizabeth City state issue, which I'll talk to you about later, and maybe we can have a chat about that on tomorrow's show. But I wanted to get you on for a quick minute this morning because I know that you were at the candlelight vigil down on the town common last night.
Yeah.
And huge crowd last night, wasn't it?
It was a very, very large crowd, at least 400 or 500 people. It was, it's a very sad occurrence, but it was a beautiful celebration that folks, no matter what political arena you live in, the gay and lesbian community, the transgender community, the straight community, everybody came out to mourn this tragedy, these horrible innocent folks that were slaughtered in the name of what we're finding out now is essentially radical Islam. Just tragic. But it was beautiful to see the entire community come together, and they read the names out loud of each of the individuals. And I think the ceremony that those folks put on yesterday was simply beautiful and very, very moving.
Yeah, it's a tough time in Orlando. And they, I don't know if you've heard the news this morning, more tragedy out of Orlando this morning, that little 2-year-old child that apparently was taken by an alligator at Disney World last night. That's just off the scale.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Isn't that crazy?
Night.
Really something.
There are evil things in our world, and it's a daily battle with evil.
Yeah, it really is.
It's a daily battle. So,
well, we'll have more time to visit.
It was a wonderful thing to see the community get together last night, and I was fortunate enough just as a spectator, just to listen to everybody and just be there with them.
Well, I wanted to get you on this morning to talk about that a second. We'll have more time to talk tomorrow. Sorry we're running so short this morning. We've had a busy show, but we will see you at the Daily Planet tomorrow morning for our Live at the Legislature show. Thank you for participating
great,
in that, too.
You providing breakfast?
Well, I'll buy you breakfast after the show, if you want.
Well, actually, I'll get you a Krispy Kreme donut.
There you go. That's all I need. There's a Krispy Kreme near the legislative building, I think.
There sure is, buddy. I used to go there during high school.
All right, Representative Murphy, we'll see you in the morning.
Have a great day.
All right, very good. Talk of the Town brought to you in part this morning by our friends at Suddenlink. It only gets better with Suddenlink. Suddenlink lets you choose the speed and data you need. If you make the switch right now, the Switch and Shout event, you get SL200 HD TV, 50 meg internet, and phone service for just $69 once a month. Once you've made the switch, you buy two and get three for only $69 a month. Call Suddenlink today, 866-432-1184, and learn more. Remember, Suddenlink has a 30-day money-back guarantee, and always they have live local customer service. McGee, we got about a minute left. Can you give us a few sports headlines?
Game 6 of the NBA Finals tomorrow night back in Cleveland. Should the Cavs win the game, they force a winner-take-all Game 7 back in Oakland coming up on Saturday.
So. Yeah. Is it going to go seven games?
I think Cleveland wins tomorrow.
I
think they win tomorrow. Force the Game 7.
I say Golden State wins.
Okay.
Want to bet something?
No. Okay. My betting as of late has been really, really bad.
All right, couple reminders as we say goodbye. Don't forget, today and tomorrow, last 2 days to register to win the Big Green Egg from Greenville TV and Appliance. We'll give it away on Friday morning. You have to go to Greenville TV and Appliance or go to Steinbeck's Men's Shop and register, and we'll give away all the prizes from Steinbeck's and the Big Green Egg on Friday morning show as we have our Father's Day show coming up Friday morning. And we'll see you tomorrow morning live from Raleigh. We'll be live at the legislature from 7 to 9 tomorrow morning at the Daily Planet Cafe, brought to you by our friends at Potash Corp Aurora, the Overton Group, Sam Jones Barbecue, Culpeper Investments, Wells Fargo Advisors, the North Carolina Hospital Association, and Greenville Auto World. See you in Raleigh tomorrow morning.
Welcome to East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep. Let us show you how quick and easy it is to buy at East Carolina. Looking for an SUV? Come check out our great lineup of Jeeps.
Lease a new Jeep Compass for just $99 a month with a Drive and Discover event. Also check out Eastern North Carolina's largest selection of Jeep Cherokees, Grand Cherokees, and Wranglers.
East Carolina Chrysler Dodge Jeep.
Come see us.
Across from the Cracker Barrel in Greenville.
Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram is now open. That's right, folks. There's a brand new beautiful dealership on Highway 264 in Washington. The city of Washington now has a new dealership focused on making your experience as comfortable and easy as possible. For the best price, selection, service, and a great customer experience, stop in to see us at the beautiful new Washington Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram on Highway 264 in Washington and visit WashingtonChrysler.com.
My prescription refills.
My son shot records.
My doctor's appointments.
My lab results.
My parents' care.
My chart.
Vidant My Chart.
Vidant My Chart is the secure online patient portal that lets you manage your health your way. Visit VidantMyChart.com or call 1-855-MYVIDANT to learn how you can sign up.
Full Service Flooring is your exclusive platinum dealer for Carndean Design Flooring. By offering a wide and impressive range of colors, textures, and finishes, you can create the looks that are unique to your home and guaranteed to last for years. Stop by Full Service Flooring today and check out our design table that makes your creations come to life. With the largest and best collection of luxury vinyl tile in Carndean, Full Service Flooring has just what you've been looking for. Visit the new showroom just off Fire Tower Road behind Chick-fil-A or give them a call at 756-9308.
Dog Academy is Eastern North Carolina's complete dog training facility. Top Dog provides an excellent environment for dogs of all ages with training services and work week daycare. Top Dog is located on Highway 43 South, just 4 miles from Bells Fork, and features a comfortable, healthy environment and a spacious facility for daycare and a brand new, beautiful facility for training. Call 752-8215 or visit topdogonline.com.
Come on out Highway 43 South to Top Dog Academy, where we know dogs.